Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is D back again with MKD5A Media, and I have another movie review for you. Now, this movie review is for the 1998 film Wild Things. All right, now Wild Things stars Matt Dillon, Kevin Bacon, Neve Campbell, Denise Richards, and Bill Murray is also in this. And there's a, you know, there's some other recognizable faces, but those are basically the main kind of big stars, the main players in this film. Now, real quick, kind of a simplified description of the plot. Matt Dillon plays Sam, who is a guidance counselor at a high school, a relatively upper class high school. And one of his students, Denise Richards, ends up accusing him of rape. And down the line, I don't really think this is a spoiler to talk about it, but down the line, Neve Campbell also comes out and accuses him of rape as well. Now, I will say, even though I'm telling you that's the plot, just know there's lots of kind of twists and turns in this movie. So the beginning, you know, the first 30 minutes, whatever, you know, nothing is really as it seems. So you got to remember that when you watch this movie, and remember that when you consider what I just told you the plot was about. But that's the initial setup. Matt Dillon is a high school counselor who gets accused of rape by two different students at his at the school he works at. And Bill Murray plays the kind of, you know, goofy, eccentric, funny lawyer that's supposed to be kind of handling, you know, representing Matt Dillon in this situation. And Kevin Bacon plays one of the detectives that's on the case investigating the situation as well. So with that being said, I'm not going to give away any of the other spoiler stuff. And there's a lot of stuff in this movie that I would consider to be spoilers for this type of film. So yeah, this is definitely a movie. If you haven't seen it, you're probably going to want to go in not knowing all the stuff that happens later on in the film, because really the fun of the film, a big part of the fun of the film, is the kind of the twists and things that they try to do. So now, I remember when this movie came out in 1998, and I didn't see it back then. My first time watching the movie ever was yesterday. So but I do remember when the movie was making the rounds back in the day, the trailers. I remember there was a lot of hype and hoopla around the film, mainly due to the fact that it had a threesome scene with Neve Campbell, Denise Richards, and Matt Dillon, and also had a girl, just a one-on-one girl-on-girl sex scene with Neve Campbell and Denise Richards. And that was, all of that was a big part of the marketing for this film. Just lots of shots of Neve Campbell and Denise Richards in the pool, and, you know, with Matt Dillon and all of them, you know, all curled up on each other and all that type of stuff. So I remember that vividly, the marketing for this film. So I finally watched it, and what I thought about this movie, I gotta be honest, I was fairly entertained by this film. Now, this is not high art at all, people. This is, and the thing that I liked about the movie, because here's the thing, the movie was not, the vibe of the movie was not at all what I expected. I actually am glad they went the route that they went. Judging by what I thought of the movie from what I had heard about it, you know, however many, you know, 20 years ago or whatever, I thought the movie was going to have a more kind of serious tone. And it actually didn't. And this movie actually kind of borderlines on like dark comedy in a way. There's a lot of things in this movie that are silly, goofy, some stuff that's downright funny, and it's intentionally so. I think this movie knows what it's trying to do. It knows what it's trying to be, and it goes for that full throttle. And so I appreciated that about it. This is a trashy, dirty film. It's a raunchy film. It's not, you know, it's not classy at all. This is it's a very film noirish in the way that it's adults, well, and, you know, I guess high school age students as well mixed in there, but adults behaving badly. Just everybody behaving badly. Majority of the characters in this movie, cops included, ultimately are behaving badly to some extent. And, you know, and because they lean into that completely, I'm able to have a good time with it because you're not looking at this through a realistic lens, and you're not looking for Oscar-worthy performances and incredible writing and all of this type of stuff. You got to accept the movie for what it is. In the same way that people that were big fans of the Fast and Furious movies, but to use the Fast and Furious movies as an example. The people that enjoy those movies, and I've enjoyed, you know, a good chunk of those movies, not all of them, but there's quite a few of them that are at least fairly entertaining from an action standpoint. But the people that enjoy those movies, they know what they're going for, and they know what they're getting. They know what it's about. They're not looking for high art. And so, and I can understand that completely. I'm not looking for Oscar performances in every movie I see. So, but like I said, this is a trashy kind of film, and I'm going to compare it to two movies, even though there's a lot of other movies you could compare it to. I'm going to compare it to, in both of these movies I've done reviews for in the past, but I'm going to compare it to this movie Fatale that came out in 2020 starring Michael Ealy and, what's her name? Hilary Swank. And I did a review for that film, and I actually enjoyed that movie for the most part. And I enjoyed it for very similar reasons, in that it's just very, very kind of trashy, very sleazy, just adults behaving badly. You know, everybody's lusty and hot and bothered all the time and all that kind of stuff. It's just very pulpy, trashy cinema. And that can be very fun when the movie leans into it and the movie is going for that. And that was what I enjoyed about Fatale. So there's some comparisons there. Now, not everything's the same. I do feel Wild Things is a lot more comedic than Fatale is, and also a lot more comedic than this other movie I'm going to mention, which is Basic Instinct. Basic Instinct always comes up periodically when I talk about noir films, because Basic Instinct is one of my just favorite noir films of all time. It's kind of it's a guilty pleasure that I actually don't feel too guilty about liking. I think it's a good movie. I think Basic Instinct is an outright good, enjoyable, fun movie. And it's in a also too, like I said, Basic Instinct leans into the trashy, sleazy, adults behaving badly mentality that a lot of kind of noir films of this type have. But again, Wild Things has a comedic side to it, a dark comedy side to it that isn't present in Basic Instinct. As sleazy and kind of trashy as Basic Instinct is, there's still a level of earnestness to it. It's still trying to be to some degree serious. It's not a comedy at all. Wild Things has a lot of funny, goofy stuff going on with it. I didn't know Bill Murray was in this movie till I started watching it. And I thought he was, you know, I thought he was kind of funny. I got a few chuckles out of some of his antics and whatnot. And just the situation in general, the movie leans into the sleaze so much that it's funny. And I think it's going for that. It's trying to do that. It's not trying to be this serious, like I always say, Oscar winner, this Oscar contender. It's not trying to win any awards. It's really just trying to entertain you. And it did that for me. In terms of acting performances, everybody does their job here. Nobody, like, once again, I keep talking about awards. Nobody's winning any awards with this movie. Nobody gave just an incredible performance. Everybody gave the performance that was necessary for the film they were trying to make. Yeah, that's kind of, this is a, you know, in today's time, you know, with today's sensibilities, there are things in this movie that would probably be considered controversial by today's standards. I mean, it was considered controversial by 1998 standards, considered some of the things that's going on. I mean, Neve Campbell and Denise Richards are portraying high school girls in this film. So some of the things that happen, if you have in the back of your mind that, wait a minute, these are high school students, yeah, if this movie came out today, there would probably be some issues from some people concerning some of the stuff that happens. I mean, but me personally, you know, I'm too old to kind of like clutch my pearls about some of the stuff that happens in movies. So I'm not gonna, you know what I mean? I'm not, that's neither here nor there. But my score for Wild Things, I can't believe I'm giving it this high of a score, but I gotta be honest. You know how I do. I don't just rate movies on kind of, you know, what they do well and the artistic merit and the performances and all that type of stuff and the writing. I don't just rate them on that, those kind of traditional, I don't want to say movie snob principles, but I'm not a movie snob. I watch movies. There's a lot of movies that I really like that are traditionally considered to be bad movies. So there's some bad movies that I'm going to give high scores to just because of what I enjoy. This movie, I'm going to give a 7 out of 10 to, which to me is a pretty high score considering how this movie behaves. You know, like this is a trashy, sleazy noir film, but it's trying to be that. So, and it does it pretty well. I'm gonna give this movie a 7 out of 10. I do recommend it if you're a fan of this type of material. If you enjoyed something like Basic Instinct, you'll probably be able to enjoy this movie, even though, like I said, it's not the same type of film all the way, because this movie, Wild Things, has a very kind of funny edge to it. There's like a undercurrent of comedy, black or dark comedy, to this movie that I found very just like intriguing, and I was surprised that it was there. So it just made the movie very kind of interesting throughout. I wasn't bored at any point in this movie. So there is that. I guess I'll just leave it there. I don't want to like force the review to be longer than it has to be. I just actually suggest, if you're into noir films, if you like if you can enjoy a sleazy scenario of just, you know, sleazy sexual situations, people trying to get money grabs, double crosses, twists and turns, just, you know, adults behaving badly, as they often do in noir films, you might be able to get something out of this. So I do recommend it for folks that are fans of that type of material. That's it. 7 out of 10 for Wild Things. I don't know if there's anything else that I can really point out. The only thing I will point out, and this is very random and probably isn't even important at all, but early on in the film, through portions of the film, Matt Dillon is he's driving this, I don't know what you call those boats. I don't know if it's called a pontoon boat or what, but those boats that they have in like the Florida Everglades and stuff that have the big fans on the back. He was using one of those. And so I was marveling at that. Like that looks like a fun ass boat to, you know, have out there on the water. So that might be something I might have to do at some point in my life, to ride on one of those boats, because that's kind of, you're like sitting high up and it's, you know, you got the big fan behind you and you're flying through the water. It just looked kind of fun. I just thought I would point that out. I know it's random, but that's it. 7 out of 10 for Wild Things. Check it out if you feel so inclined. Thank you for watching. As always, more stuff coming. Until the next time, I will catch you on the next go round.